So good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. We were just saying it feels like it's forever since we've all been together, but it's only been 2 weeks. So I'm sure we've got a lot of great updates. So I want to start by introducing myself. I'm Kayley, and I'm the Vice President for the Hastings Business Women's Network. And I'm joined by Leslie Williams, Danielle, Sandra, and Kelly this morning. Each of them will introduce themselves and then provide an update, and then we'll take any questions from our members and guests who have joined us this morning. So I'm going to start with you, Leslie, if that's okay, if you can start with an intro and an update from your point of view for our listeners today.
Well, thanks, Kayley. Yes, she mentioned Leslie Williams, State Member for Port Macquarie, and it's great to be here again. I think, like most people, I'm just shaking my head thinking, how did we get to the middle of June? In just, a blink of an eyelid. It's really incredible. And to think about what's happened over the last 3 or 4 months it's really mind-boggling. But I think that certainly what we've seen across the state, but also locally in our community, is that particularly businesses, but also our community, have adapted really well to what has been an unprecedented pandemic. And let's hope that from here onwards, it's one step forward all the way. But that's only going to happen if people continue to comply with the restrictions that are in place. And obviously, they are easing considerably, have over the last couple of days, but again, in the weeks ahead. But the 1.5 social distancing applies at all times. You really need to make sure that we continue to maintain that distance because none of us want to go back to where we were before and the restrictions that we had early in March, because that was really tough, particularly for our small businesses. And we need to get behind them, get supporting them. And the one way that we can really do some damage is if we don't continue to comply with 1.5 social distancing rule, continue your own personal hygiene, washing your hands, using hand sanitizer, and so on. And of course, if you're not feeling well, the clear message is do not go to work. Do not go to work. Do not go to school if you're not well. Go and get tested for COVID. We still have the testing clinics there. They're available. And of course, finally, make sure that you have the COVID Safe app downloaded, because that's really going to help. If we do suddenly have a new case, say in Port Macquarie, we can track very easily where that person's been and who else potentially had contact with them. But I guess in terms of restrictions, of course, Saturday was a big day. Saturday the 13th of June, we saw lots of the restrictions ease in New South Wales, particularly around gatherings, religious gatherings now up to 50, weddings now up to 20 people, lots of new businesses and services that were closed previously now allowed to be open. Particularly great, of course, for our local things like Billabong Zoo, some of our tourism facilities coming up to the July school holidays will be open. And be able to take in those customers. We did announce yesterday that on July the 1st will be the next set of changes in terms of easing of restrictions. And I guess fairly broadly, what it's going to mean is that the one person per 4 square metre rule will apply. So in other words, it means that you can have, there'll be different number of people allowed in different venues depending on the size of the venue. And I think that's something that's particularly going to be welcomed by our local clubs, because obviously they're quite big facilities, but they've been restricted up till the 1st of July in terms of the number of people they had, because it wasn't based, in fact, on their space, but just rather you are a club and therefore you're going to be treated the same as pubs and restaurants and so on. So that will basically change on the 1st of July. And so the real key when it comes to working out how many people can be in venues will be that there's one person per 4 square metres, of course. But making sure, of course, along the way that businesses have in place a COVID safe plan to make sure they can manage those people coming through the doors. And we've also just flagged that hopeful that everything will go to plan, that we will start easing more restrictions on the 1st of August. I guess one of the real challenging things and what you're seeing in the media is the debate about border closures. And for us on the Mid-North Coast, the impact is that the Queensland border is still closed and they're not providing a date of when that may open. And obviously coming up to July school holidays, that will have an impact on our tourism. And so we're all keeping our fingers crossed that they might announce a date sooner rather than later. South Australia, of course, the only state that has a closed border, that has announced that they will be opening on the 20th of July. So that's good news. Not great for me when my kids live in Perth, because I don't know when Western Australia is going to open. But anyway, we're hopeful that we'll see those borders start opening, the ones who have closed, so that, you know, again, we know very well that has an impact on our local businesses here. And I guess the last comment I want to make is about the government's real focus now. Not that we've taken our eyes off the health aspect of COVID, but what we're now trying to do is put people back into jobs, because at the end of the day, there are tens of thousands of people in New South Wales who no longer have a job because of COVID. So we are making sure that we're going to invest in our infrastructure, and where there are infrastructure projects that are ready to go, we are going to try and bring them forward, whether it's about supporting councils or supporting private enterprise. We want to get jobs happening. We want to get infrastructure being built sooner rather than later. And so one of my focuses, certainly in the past few weeks, but in the weeks going forward, is talking to ministers about, you know, what projects potentially in Port Macquarie we can get off the ground and get moving, so we can get people back into jobs as soon as possible. I'll leave it on that note, but as I said, I'm going to apologise in advance that I'm going to have to leave at the session early. But, you know, again, just really want to reiterate the importance of continuous social distancing, your personal hygiene, and, you know, making sure that you comply with the restrictions that are in place.
Great. Thank you so much, Liz. A really strong and clear message there for all of us. And it might have a direct impact on our tourism if Queensland continue to have their borders closed, particularly for these school holidays, for people from down south. Won't make it as far as the border. But yeah, definitely made it really clear for us around what we do know and what we don't know. And as these restrictions do ease, I know that we really appreciate you kind of making things really clear for us and helping us kind of get back to something that resembles normal. So well done. And thank you in advance if you do need to leave early. Thanks, before we move on, I might just go to the group and see if anyone has any questions for Leslie, just in the event that she does need to leave before we finish. And I can see from the chat that there's nothing in there. So what we might do, Leslie, is let you off the hook and we'll move on to Danielle. So thanks again for coming on this morning.
No worries. And Kayley, as always, you know, we've got the website and we'll be updating it today with the new restrictions, but also our office is open now. But has been obviously working offline. So people just need to contact us if they've got any questions that they need some support with.
Okay, thanks so much. And remember also their Facebook group as well, which is a really great one that Leslie manages. So thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Danielle, thanks for attending on behalf of Cara.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks, Kayley. My name is Danielle Maltman. I'm a business consultant at Seachange Hills Consultancy. In talking about all the impacts that our regional area has had, I suppose, since last year, particularly in the Port Macquarie area, there's a number of funding, particularly coming from the New South Wales State Government for bushfire funding and COVID grants. Now, the COVID grants actually, well, go to COVID first. The support out there for small business in particular, there's some great grants for COVID, one of which closes on the 30th of June. So everybody sort of needs to get wriggle on and get their applications in for that type of funding. Also the bushfire funding. Now the bushfire funding came out last year and it's still available. It is for our area. People in this area are compliant to apply in Port Macquarie. These small business grants and loans to help small business recover. So there's small business grants up to $10,000, and there's also recovery grants for $50,000. And there's also concessional loans as well. Now, the concessional loans are from the Rural Assistance Authority and they expire on close on the 4th of August. So there is a lot of funding and support out there from the government, and people need to be looking at applying at this time and getting those applications in as soon as they can. That's pretty much it for me.
Okay, thank you. I'm just making note of that. So some really critical dates, but also information about grants, loans, funding. You know, CG Hills Consulting can definitely help you with that. So thanks again, Danielle. I can see that there's no immediate questions, so we might move on to you, Sandra. I can see a message from Leslie who's needing to go. So thank you so much, and thanks again for continuing to keep us really, really well updated, Leslie.
My pleasure. Have a great day.
Thank you. Okay, Sandra, what is happening in the world of accounting and tax and navigating all the new things that are suddenly becoming everyday terminology for us?
Okay, good morning, Kayley. Good morning, everyone. Thanks for having me again. My name's Sandra Magann. I'm the principal accountant at Seachange Accounting. We're a team of five accountants working usually out of Gordon Street, but working remotely for the last 2 months. Usually we're helping businesses and individuals with their tax and cloud accounting and technology needs. For the last 2 months, we've been helping businesses on a range of government stimulus measures, particularly JobKeeper. But there are some other COVID measures that impact and are available for individuals and businesses. And coming up to tax time, I just wanted to cover off some of those before June 30. Just a quick update on JobKeeper. We've now gone through two cycles of JobKeeper, so most businesses would have already claimed for the April and May JobKeeper. Going forward, it's still available for businesses to opt in and enrol if they're eligible. There has been an extension for the time to do that. So that was just announced in the last week or so. So businesses now have until the end of the month to enrol for that particular month. Prior to that, they had to enrol by the end of the fortnight that they wanted to opt in for. So if they do still qualify for June, they've got till the end of June to enrol for that. Just moving on to some of the COVID measures that are available for individuals. There's a new simplified rate of 80 cents per hour for those people working from home that they can claim to cover the expenses on their tax return. There's also the early access to super up to $10,000 that's available to June 30, and then another $10,000 is available for the next financial year, so from 1st of July, and that income's not assessable income. For businesses, employees, obviously we've got JobKeeper, which is assessable income. But the cash flow boost that's available to employees that should have started coming through from the March BAS and will also be coming through on the June and September BAS, that's non-assessable income. So that's a cash flow boost for businesses that's either been received as a refund or a credit on their tax account. The other main thing is the instant asset write-off is available. That's $150,000. For assets up to $150,000, new or used. The deadline for that was June 30. That's now been extended to the 31st of December. So that's been extended for 6 months. However, if you were to purchase any of those assets before June, then they become deductible in this financial year, the 2020 financial year. The only other thing I wanted to mention was their Treasury will be doing a midway review of the JobKeeper scheme, and we're expecting that they're going to be handing down the results of that on the 23rd of July. So the Treasurer the rules do allow for changes to the JobKeeper scheme. So at this stage, we're not sure what that's going to look like, but there is a review underway at the moment. And that will be available on the 23rd of July.
Thank you so much, Sandra. I'm just clicking through because I can see that there is a question from Kelly, and she's asking if there's any changes anticipated on JobKeeper.
Well, that most of that will come out in the review, Kelly, on the 23rd of July. So there is speculation that for some businesses, it may be wound down. So there were some recent changes made to childcare businesses so that JobKeeper is no longer available for certain childcare businesses from the 20th of July. So it may be that there are more tests that are in place to continue to be eligible for JobKeeper. And it may be that it's not available for certain businesses, or it may be extended for certain businesses that are still impacted by COVID. So we'll just need to wait until the 23rd of July to see what comes out.
Makes sense. Great. Thank you so much, Sandra. And I can see from the chat that Kelly is saying thank you as well. So I guess that means that answered her question as much as you can crystal ball on these things. So what we might do is go to questions. Kelly, do you have any other questions for Sandra or Danielle?
No other questions. I think that, from our perspective, it's good for members to be aware of the deadlines and all the changes that are happening on a weekly basis. So all of the ladies have really covered what those requirements are, which is fabulous. But on a HBWN perspective, just to remind our members that we do have our annual general meeting rescheduled and running via Zoom on the 25th of June. So that'll be at 5:30. And we don't anticipate that will be a long meeting, but it will be an opportunity if people do want to jump online and connect with each other. 5:30 in the afternoon is wine time as well for anyone that wants to bring their own wine along and have a glass of wine with us. So please join us for that. And we do anticipate that potentially will be the last online event for HBWN, and we are hoping that we'll be moving back to our live events from July. So stay tuned for more information about some exciting news on that front.
Yeah, definitely. Thanks, Kelly. And it'd be lovely to see lots of faces on Zoom for that meeting. So that's great. Any questions from you, Donna? Happy for you to continue listening. But, definitely for those who are listening into the recorded session, we're still getting lots of positive feedback, which is really good. I know a lot of people are finding listening to it in their own time is really beneficial. And I know we really appreciate just the continual updates. And sometimes it is just a reminder of things that we might have already been aware of, but just brings it back to the front of our mind. Things like Sandra, you're talking about deadlines, and we know that, we can come here for a source of truth about that. And just a reminder constantly from the different grants and loans that are available to us. And again, deadlines, because that's what keeps shifting, often extended. And of course, it's always great to have Leslie's statewide perspective shared with us as well. So we've got a couple of exciting guest speakers lined up in the coming fortnights. So we are going to continue having these sessions because we are getting really great feedback from them. So big thank you to those who have joined us today. And for those who are listening into the recorded session, thanks so much for your continued support. And we'll see you again in a fortnight. I'm just going to stop the recording now, and then we can say goodbye in a more informal way. So I'm just stopping now.